Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Very warm welcome to our Sam Fellowship tonight, and a very special welcome if you're here for the first time. Tonight we're going to look at the subject of hope and despair. And we're going to do that by looking at our glad hearts. And what we're about to see now is a dance entitled Under the Gun. And if you have young children out there, then I'll please ask that you just keep in mind that this is a bit dramatic and it could upset the kids. Just also keep in mind also that everybody has different aspects of what is a disaster and how it affects them. And through what you're about to see on stage, we're going to address that and what hopes you can possibly have, what your hopes are, what our hopes are, and just see what they are through what you see on stage.
Thank you. gentlemen's campaign. We attend all the classic seatbelt signs in preparation for landing. Weather is clear. The temperature is 80 degrees. We will be landing in about 15 minutes.
We have taken over the land. I am your new captain. We have the bomb. Today, you will see and your attempt to board a new world be shot.
September 11th, 2001. It is a day that will be etched in history. engraved in stone and in our memories, the day of the attack on America.
Oh, yeah. I'd like us to sit here in silence and think about what we've just seen. And I'd like us to put ourselves in the plains and to imagine, just for a moment. Let's just sit in silence. I wonder what you thought. I wonder how many of you are sitting here tonight and have never ever experienced a disaster of that kind of proportion, obviously. But all of us have experienced disasters of one kind or another, whether they seem to be small or large in the life of what we've looked at. God, I want to ask you this question. Some of you won't know what these words mean, but do you know what they mean? Titanic, Chernobyl, the Exxon Valdez, the Hindenburg, Kansas City Heights, the USS Freshet, 3 Mile Island, nuclear plant, TWA Flight 800. Challenger, Space Shuttle, Estonia, the Fury, Aloha Flight, and then one you probably won't know, the Sultana, the bomb of something that was to be eaten. 1865. Sultana steamboat that sailed up the Mississippi River had at one point a little crack and the boilers that stopped and the boiler maker who was well still there repaired the boiler. The ship sailed up and they came to a port on the river and they stopped and the ship wasn't meant to be carrying anybody else, but there was a little bit of bribery, a little bit of money exchanged hands. About 1,860 soldiers who were waiting to go up the river. There were other boats in the port at the time on that river, but nonetheless, they all loaded on this ship. 2,154 people on one ship on the Mississippi River. We don't know what happened to this day really, but we do know that somehow the boilers split and burst. In those days, they had a catastrophe where you needed 2 or 3 people killed. This was one of the largest and most incredible events that the people in history faced. 1,238 of those people died. They either were killed or in a short pack or, like many of them, they couldn't even swim. So they drowned. Some of you know the story of the Challenger, but what you don't know, if you haven't done the research, the stuff that wasn't covered on the news was it wasn't quite as it was portrayed. You see, one of the things I had given the CBBC on the news broadcast, what a terrible catastrophe. One of the representatives from NASA said they would have died instantly. But there have been a number of reports down on the whole system. We now know that at least some of the crew, maybe even all of the crew, lived for 2 minutes possibly, maybe 2 minutes, 45 seconds, knowing that was about to happen. the 11-hour flight. What we can hear much about here in some seasons compared to the TWA flight 800. A lot for those who might remember of the first class cabin area, the top of the plane got a crack and poof and disappeared. One of the stewards went with them and was bashed back inside the aircraft as he flew out. People sat in that plane and the roof section was in our first class, the plane was very much fixed. Part of the amazing job he managed to land it, and that was the only fatality that happened from that fire. Now a lot of people were injured, a few bits and pieces flying around. But all these instances of the situations and disasters that we don't anticipate living in, that we never see ourselves ever facing. We see something maybe not so large for us. Let's put it in perspective. I've got some quotes that have come from children and young adults. They wrote these things. Being titled out of the mouths of babes. Here's the disasters. Never trust a dog to watch your food, says Patrick H.T. The next one I found to be a very serious moment for me in my own day. Don't flush the dawn when your dad's in the shower. Once again, H.T. When your dad is there and asks you, do I know it's stupid? Don't answer them. Either age 16. Never tell your mum your diet isn't working. Michael, age 40. Never be a little brother to paint your family car. Philip, age 17. See, they all have disasters, and they all have injustice in you. For those you know, we face things in our lives that have serious implications at the time, and the intensity of the implication is only related to the previous experience we've had. As well as my mother, one of these religious stories, is told as long ago, quite like that, like, it's a poor joke. We'll call it as a black head joke, you know, when he was around. It's a black head person on a meeting, he meets in the bar. And they were having a drink.
Been changed by the September 11th meeting. Here we go.
Thank you. Thank you. was under acute pain. In the end, I got admitted to the hospital after a number of days and getting treatment. I was laying in the hospital and they had six doctors come and have them climb and wake me and look at me and they done all these other tests and things. And in the end, about Paul talks about Just grab all the weapons connection, a very, very real connection between the whole issue of hope and faith. You see, the message is clear. We do not need to face this with no hope. Death is the thing that most of us fear most unless we have a good hope.
Got work out loud.
Thank you.